Hello, everyone. Welcome to the webcast. I'm Kiran Panaka, and I'm the product manager for analytics here at Viewpoint. In today's Ready, Set, Report webinar, we will cover self-service Vista reporting on the web through Viewpoint Analytics. Please stay tuned till the end of the webcast, where we will have a short survey. And it's extremely important for us to for you to take the survey, as we can serve you better. All right, let's begin. So if you have answered yes to any one of these questions, you're the right webinar. If you're trying to figure out how to use Crystal SSRS and you're still using those legacy reporting solutions to get to your Vista data, or if you've heard of analytics, or sorry, if you've not heard of analytics, you're unfamiliar with Viewpoint Analytics, and you don't know how to access this on the web, you're the right webinar too. And if you've already heard of Viewpoint Analytics, but there's a huge barrier to start using analytics because you have to sit down and import all the projects from Vista into Team one by one. And that's why you're not able to get a wide adoption of Viewpoint Analytics at your company. You're also in the right webinar today because we're going to touch on a very important aspect where you don't have to import all those projects. You can directly start using analytics without getting in Team projects into Team. So a little bit of Viewpoint Analytics, and after that, I'll jump to the demo and show you how Vista reporting works. A quick summary is Viewpoint Analytics comes out with a set of comprehensive standard reporting that allows you to quickly get going on your Vista data. It also gives you a set of tools that allows you to create your own custom reports to cater to your business needs, different questions that you ask that are not similar to the other companies. With these set of reports and metrics, you can be confident to elevate the quality of your decision-making because now you have your trusted data that you know comes from your Vista instance. And if you create these reports and metrics, you would like to share with your peers so you're all talking about the same data, you're speaking the same language. And you can do that very securely using Viewpoint Analytics because part of Viewpoint One cloud solution. So whatever security we have there, this also adheres to that. Feel free to follow along as I move through the different windows in Viewpoint Analytics. And you can also click on the link if you want to understand how to set up a new user in Viewpoint Analytics. Okay, I'm going to now jump into the demo. Before I jump into the entire Vista reporting option, I want to quickly showcase something we recently released. Earlier, if you get into analytics, you go straight to a folder structure on the left pane. But now you can click on the analytics label there, or you can click on analytics regardless. It'll take you now to a landing page. And this is based on feedback we have received from some of our users, basically saying, look, once we get into analytics, it's really hard for us to understand where we need to go to do an action, to perform an action. And if we need help, it's really hard for us to go locate help. If I need to see videos, again, I have to get out of the application and go do so. And these are great ways for me to learn. And how do I do that with Viewpoint Analytics without getting my users and me confused? So we curated a landing page content where you can quickly launch your favorite reports, your personal reports, your company's public reports, and the standard reports that we produce. And you can also quickly get to the analytics links, help links. You can click on the label, it'll take you directly to the site, or you can click on any specific topic so you can get started right away. And you also have quick access to your video tutorials, which will keep refreshing on a regular basis. And this is great because you can it's on a carousel, so you can look at other popular videos and click on any one of them at any given time. And if you want to quickly give us a feedback, an idea, or a suggestion, you now have a simple link right there instead of going to the settings menu and resource center to do so. Okay, and also you can quickly create a report right from the landing page. You don't have to go into the reports menu and then start creating a report. Okay, now for my favorite part. Now I'm going to talk about reporting on your Vista data. And I want to preface this by saying that this does not require you to bring in all the projects that you may have in Vista into Team. If you have 20 projects, 100 projects, 1,000 projects, Doesn't matter. If you don't bring it into a team, you can still still use analytics to report on that data. For example, I'll show you, before I jump into that, let me show you that I'm going to look for a specific project. It's called Steel Tank. And I'm just going to demonstrate that I did not bring this project into team. And now let me go into analytics. And by the way, I'm a power user, which means I have access, data access, more than maybe other folks. And I'll show you what that means as well. Because of my data access and my security, now I want to run a specific report, contract summary report, that Viewpoint has given me out of the box as a standard report. And as you can see, I have a lot of projects that I have access to. And I can guarantee you, not all of these projects are in team. For example, we look for the steel tank, right? That's just an example. There are several other projects that I did not bring into team, but now we can easily report on them from Viewpoint Analytics. This is your project that you have in Vista, but you did not import into team, but you're able to report on that. And we also baked in a filter, which states that report only on jobs that are open right now. So if you want to report on jobs that are closed, hard, soft, whatever the case may be, you can simply remove that filter, and this will render all those projects you have in Vista for any job status. I don't have any jobs that are not open, so that's why I don't see a new record. But if you do, you'll have a lot more jobs here. You may see that it will only produce a certain number of rows, which means you may have to filter on a specific status. But regardless, you can bring in all the projects, and you can report on all the projects at all times using Viewpoint Analytics. Okay, so now you're wondering, how am I setting this up so that my company can have this, right? So you do still need team to be set up. So once team is set up, all you have to do is, I'm going to go to the admin center. If you're the enterprise admin for your company, this is where it becomes important to you to understand how you can set up analytics to all projects. So the way it works today is all projects is set up at the user level. So your enterprise already has access to all projects. We took care of that behind the scenes. So now it comes down to, who do you want to give access to all projects within your company? So when you go to user management, you find out, find the person that you want to give access to. If there is no one here yet, you can quickly add a user and provide their credentials. And once they accept your invite, you can come back and give them a specific role to analytics. Let's say you already have done that. Now I'm going to look for that user, and then I'm going to edit their record. And now you can see a new option that says all projects includes ERP. So what this is saying, that if you have specific business units mapped already, and if you click on all projects, this user will see everything you have in your Vista instance today. If you don't like to do that, you can always go back to giving a specific business unit for that user. So that way, now that user can see everything. It's very important for you to understand that when they look at all projects, whether or not you have a business unit set up in team, they'll be able to see all the companies that are not in team. So if you want to be able to, if you want the option to control further down, please make sure that you map specific business units to specific company. So that way, you can come back to your user management window, and you can further control their data access by providing this user with just a specific business unit that you want them to see. Even though you don't have all the projects in team, as long as you have your company and business units mapped, you're now able to provide even further data security for your users. And that's the way you're going to control what they can see in Viewpoint Analytics. Okay, and that's pretty much what we had today as far as demo concerned for all projects in Vista reporting. Unfortunately, I have time. I'm running out of time. So if you have any question, please put your questions down here in the chat or comment section, depending on where you're seeing the webcast. And we also appreciate if you fill out your post live webinar survey. And I'll make sure that I'll come back and answer these questions for you. And thank you, please, and have a great day.